Welcome to engineering physics. That is interference and diffraction. Interference and diffraction. So did in your intermediate also. What is interference? What is diffraction? You have studied in your intermediate. You have studied in your intermediate. So first, interference, starting with principle of superposition of waves. Superposition of waves. Simply you remember the principle of superposition or superposition principle. Resultant y is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 and so on. That is principle of superposition. Y is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 and so on. What is the definition of principle of superposition of waves? When two waves or more waves travel through the same portion of the medium simultaneously, the resultant displacement at any point is the vector sum of the displacements due to individual waves are called principle of superposition. Principle of superposition. When two or three or more waves travel through the same portion of the medium simultaneously, the resultant displacement at any point is the vector sum or vector addition of the displacement due to individual waves are called principle of superposition. So let individual waves y1, y2, y3 and so on, resultant capital R is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 and so on. And so on. You can see here. So y is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3. What is the definition? You can see here. When two or more waves travel through the same portion of a medium simultaneously, the resultant displacement at any point is the vector sum y1 plus y2 plus y3, vector sum of the displacements due to individual waves y1, y2, y3. That is called principle of superposition of waves. Superposition of waves. Important cases you can observe. First one, so interference. Two waves of same frequency moving in the same direction. Two points are here. One is the same frequency moving in the same direction. If it is not the same frequency, that is beats. Slight difference in frequency, that is beats. You have studied in your intermediate beats. Two waves of same frequency moving in the opposite direction. That is stationary wave. That is stationary wave. You can see. What is interference of waves? Two waves of same frequency moving in same direction. That is interference. Two waves of slightly different frequencies moving in same direction. Beats. That is beats. So, two waves of same frequency moving in opposite direction. That is stationary wave. You can observe on the screen. So what I am saying, principle of superposition, y is equal to y1 plus y2 plus y3 and so on. Just remember the important superposition of waves. Two waves of same frequency moving in the same direction. That is interference. That's all. That is interference. So what is constructive interference and destructive interference? You studied in your intermediate. If the two displacements, you can see here, yes, I am giving pen option. This is color option, right? So you see, if the two displacements y1 and y2, so you can see here, this is y1, this is y2, marking here, you can observe here. If two displacements y1 and y2 are moving in the same direction, not opposite, moving in the same direction, then the resultant displacement is equal to R is equal to y1 plus y2. Y1 plus y2. So this is crust. So this is trough. Trough. The crust of one wave y1 is combined with crust of another wave y2. Then it gets maximum displacement, resultant vector displacement, maximum amplitude. So it produces maximum displacement, that is called constructive superposition. So for example, intensity I is directly proportional to displacement square. So displacement square, displacement is maximum, intensity also maximum, it produces maximum intensity. Phenomena is called constructive interference. You see here, when crust of one wave is combined with crust of another wave, or trough of one wave is combined with the trough of another wave, it produces maximum displacement and maximum intensity of light wave. Phenomena is called constructive interference. When crust falls on crust or trough falls on trough, a maximum displacement is produced, is called constructive superposition. It produces maximum intensity, so it is called constructive interference. Constructive interference. That is the constructive interference. Second one. You see, if two displacements, y1 and y2, opposite to each other, opposite direction, you see here, so this is x direction, this is y direction. So it is moving, one wave is moving in one direction, this is y1, in one direction. So it is moving with opposite direction. This is y2. This is y2. So its resultant wave, this is minimum amplitude. So this is resultant wave. This is capital R. Resultant wave, capital R. So resultant wave displacement R is equal to y1 minus y2, or vector sum y1 plus of minus y2. This is vector sum. Vector sum. So here, if two displacements y1 and y2 are opposite direction, then the resultant displacement R is equal to y1 minus y2. So destructive interference, when crust fall on the trough, so this is first wave, this is crust, this is trough. The crust of one wave combined with trough of another wave, or trough of one wave, here trough of this is crust of another wave, this is trough of one wave. One wave. One second. I am erasing. Yes. So here, this is crust. This is trough. The trough of one wave is combined with crust of another wave. Or the crust of one wave combined with trough of another wave. It produces minimum displacement, is called destructive superposition. It produces minimum intensity, so it is called destructive interference. Destructive interference. The modification in the destruction of intensity in the region of superposition is known as interference.